Okay, by the numbers. We just need to find... Find... What is that?
Nothing's ever simple, is it?
Invaders, your every step is a transgression. A thousand feelers appraise you as meat, good only to dig or decompose. I speak for the old growth as I did for Saren. You are within and before the Thorian. It commands that you be in awe.
You gave something to Saren. Something I need.
Saren sought knowledge of those who are gone. The old growth listened to flesh for the first time in the long cycle. Trades were made. Then cold ones began killing the flesh that would tend the next cycle. Flesh fairly given. The old growth sees the air you push as lies. It will listen no more.
I don't argue with plans. Give me what I want, now.
The Thorian is a piece of this world, extending across the land and back through the ages. You can no more kill it than cut the sky. Your blood will feed the ground and the new growth!
Here, Commander. Worth looking at.
Area secured.
Start. We'll bring it down yet.
all targets down.
Thank you. Perimeter clear.
That's it. Bag 'em and tag 'em.
Thank you.
signal. Target online. Targets down.
Thank you for releasing me.
How did you end up inside that thing?
My name is Shiala. I served Matriarch Benezia. When she allied herself with Saren, so did I. Benezia foresaw the influence Saren would have. She joined him to guide him down a gentler path. But Saren is compelling. Benezia lost her way.
Are you saying Saren can control minds?
Benezia underestimated Saren, as I did. We came to believe in his cause and his goals. The strength of his influence is troubling.
Sounds like you Asari got in over your heads for once.
Asari matriarchs are among the most intelligent and powerful beings in the galaxy. How could one fall under Saren's control?
Saren has a vessel, an enormous warship unlike anything I've ever seen. He calls it Sovereign. It can dominate the minds of his followers. They become indoctrinated to Saren's will. The process is subtle. It can take days, weeks, but in the end, it is absolute. I was a willing slave when Saren brought me to this world. He needed my biotics to communicate with the Thorian to learn its secrets. Saren offered me in trade. I was sacrificed to secure an alliance between Saren and the Thorian.
Then why were the Geth trying to destroy the Thorian?
After Saren had what he needed, the Thorian became a liability. Saren knows you are searching for the Conduit. He knows you are following his steps. He attacked the Thorian so you could not gain the Cypher.
What's the Cypher? Why did Saren need it?
The beacon on Eden Prime gave you visions. But the visions are unclear, confusing. They were meant for a Prothean mind. To truly comprehend them, you must think like a Prothean. You must understand their culture, their history, their very existence. The Thorian was here long before the Protheans built this city. It watched and studied them. When they died, it consumed them. They became a part of it.
So the Thorian taught Saren to think like a Prothean. How?
The Cypher is the very essence of being a Prothean. It cannot be described or explained. It would be like describing color to a creature without eyes. To understand, you must have access to endemic ancestral memory, a viewpoint spanning thousands of Prothean generations. I sensed this ancestral memory, the Cypher, when I melded with the Thorian. Our identities merged, our minds intertwined. Such knowledge cannot be taught. It simply exists.
I need the Cypher.
There is a way. I can transfer the knowledge from my mind to yours, as I did to Saren. Try to relax, Commander. Slow, deep breaths. Let go of your physical shell. Reach out to grasp the threads that bind us, one to another. Every action sends ripples across the galaxy. Every idea must touch another mind to live. Each emotion must mark another's spirit. We are all connected. Every living being united in a single, glorious existence. Open yourself to the universe, Commander. Embrace eternity. I have given you the Cypher, just as it was given to Saren. The ancestral memories of the Protheans are part of you now.
What just happened? Are you okay?
I saw something. It still didn't make any sense.
You have been given a great gift, the experience of an entire people. It will take time for your mind to process this information.
You look a little queasy. We should get you back to the ship.
I'm sorry if you have suffered, but there was no other way. You needed the cipher. In time, it will help you understand the vision from the beacon.
I want to know more about you.
There is nothing remarkable about me. I was merely one of Matriarch Benezia's disciples. For nearly 2 centuries, I followed her, learning at her feet. When Benezia revealed her plan to join Saren, she gave her disciples a choice. Only those who were willing had to follow her. Many felt her plan was too dangerous. But I believed in her. I thought she could turn Saren away from his insanity. Instead, we joined him in it.
Now that you're free of the Thorian, what are you planning to do next?
If you allow it, I would like to stay here with the colonists. They have suffered greatly, and I've played a role in their suffering. I would like to make amends.
The colonists will need all the help they can get. They'll be happy to have you on their side.
Thank you, Commander. May fortune smile upon you.
You did it. With the Thorian gone, we can start rebuilding for ourselves again. And we're free of Exogeni's threats. We're back to being just a little nowhere colony. Thank you, Commander.
I would be so thrilled to see a soldier. Forgive my previous inaction, but under the Thorian's influence, every thought was examined, filtered.
Let me see what you have in stock.
Of course. Return in the future, and I may even have more to see.
Thank you.
need the power cells for this generator, though.
Would it help if I brought in some power cells from the Normandy? We can certainly spare a few.
Your top-of-the-line ship doesn't use the same parts as the old generator we've got. Cells just aren't compatible.
If I find anything while I'm looking around, I'll send it your
way. Thank you, Commander. I appreciate it.
It will take time for things to get back to normal around here.
Thank you for everything you did.
You were at the Skillian Blitz, right? Never thought someone like you would help us.
I will do what I can to assist the colony in this difficult time. I am ashamed of the damage done to the lives of these people.
Tell me more about this ship Saren has.
Sovereign is alien. I do not know how it was built or where it comes from. Its design does not match that of any known space-faring species. It dwarfs any vessel in the Citadel or Alliance fleets. Its weapons are devastating. His defenses virtually impenetrable. With it, Saren believes he is unstoppable.
You said Saren uses it to manipulate his followers.
The indoctrination. There is an energy about Sovereign. You feel drawn to the ship. It makes Saren's arguments more persuasive, more compelling. Spend enough time in Sovereign's presence and you will lose yourself. There is no other way to explain it.
Farewell, Shiela.
Farewell, Commander. I wish you well in your hunt.
Stand by, Shore Party. Decontamination is in progress.
Commander, you look pale. Are you suffering any ill effects from the cipher?
I just need some time to let this cipher do its thing.
I might be able to help you. I am an expert on the Protheans. If I join my consciousness to yours, maybe we can make some sense of it.
Do it. Hurry. We don't have much time.
Relax, Commander. Embrace eternity. That was incredible. All this time, all my research, yet I never dreamed. I am sorry. The images were so vivid. I never imagined the experience would be so intense. You are remarkably strong-willed, Commander. What you have been through, what you have seen, would have destroyed a lesser mind.
Come on, get to the point. What did you see?
The beacon on Eden Prime must have been badly damaged. Large parts of the vision are missing. The data transferred into the Commander's mind is incomplete.
You sure you didn't come across any kind of clue or hint? Something we might have missed?
Everything I saw, you already know. You were right about the Reapers. The Protheans were destroyed by a race of sentient machines. I think it is obvious there is a connection between the Reapers, the Prothean extinction, and the Conduit. But I did not see anything that would help us find it.
What's our next move?
I was able to interpret the data relayed through your vision. What was there, at least. But something was missing. Saren must have the missing information. Maybe he found another beacon. If we can find the missing data from your vision, I can... Oh. I am sorry. The joining is exhausting. I should go to the medical bay and lie down for a moment.
Dr. Chakwas should take a look at you.
That will not be necessary. I just need some rest. Somewhere quiet.
We're done here. Dismissed.
I've sent off the Pharos report, Commander. You want me to patch it through to the Council?
Don't bother.
Aye, aye, sir.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
How did you end up serving on an alliance?
Those weren't given to me as charity for my disease.
What are you talking about? Are you sick?
You mean you didn't know? Oh, crap. Okay, I've got Froelich syndrome, brittle bone disease. The bones in my legs never develop properly. They're basically hollow, too much force, and they'll shatter. Even with crutches and my leg braces, it's hard to get around. One wrong step and crack! It's very dramatic. But I've learned to manage my condition, Commander. Put the Normandy in my hands and I'll make her dance for you. Just don't ask me to get up and dance unless, you know, you like the sound of snapping shin bones.
Why does everyone call you Joker?
It's a lot shorter than saying Alliance Flight Lieutenant Jeff Moreau. Plus, I love to make little children laugh.
I was just thinking how much you remind me of Santa Claus.
Look, I didn't pick the name. One of the instructors in flight school used to bug me about never smiling. She started calling me Joker, and it stuck.
I have to go.
All right, see ya. Good timing, Commander. We got a transmission coming in from the Citadel. Top priority clearance.
Is it the Ambassador?
It's not his signature. I think it's from the Council. I'll patch it through to the comm room. Good timing, Commander. We got a transmission coming in from the Citadel. Top priority clearance.
Commander Shepard. We've received information that made critical to your mission against Saren.
I'll take all the help I can get.
We've received an urgent message from one of our infiltration regiments in the Traverse.
I'm listening.
We currently have several infiltration units scattered throughout the border regions of Citadel space. This particular unit was gathering intel on Saren.
What did they find?
Unfortunately, the message we received was little more than static. The infiltration team must be in a situation where they can't set up proper interstellar communications. But the message was sent on a channel reserved for mission-critical communications. Whatever they were trying to tell us, we know it was important. Considering your interest in Saren, we thought you might want to investigate this. Find out what happened to our team. The signal originated from the planet Vermeer.
I'll look into it.
The Council prefers not to become involved in the specifics of Spectre activities. We only want you to be aware of all your options, including Vermeer. Good luck, Commander Shepard. We will keep you advised if we learn anything else.
Thank you.
Commander, urgent message from Alliance Command coming in. I'll patch it through.
Shepard, this is Admiral Hackett from Alliance Command. We've got a situation here, and you're the only one that can handle it.
What do you need, Admiral?
There's an Alliance training ground where we test weapons and technology in live-fire simulations. One of the VIs we use to simulate enemy tactics in the drills is no longer responding to our override commands. It's gone rogue.
Just tell me how to stop it, Admiral.
We need you to fight your way through the training ground of the VI core and manually disable it.
Don't worry, Admiral. I'll take that thing out.
I know Spectre's answered the Council, but you're still human. You're still part of the Alliance military, and right now we need you. The VI controls all the facilities, weapons, drones, and automated defenses. You're the only one that can pull this off, Shepard. Good luck.
The asteroid will collide with Terra Nova in approximately 4 hours.
right direction. I don't know who you are, but I'm... Damn it.
Enemy contact.
Release the Baron!
mine. Was that you? Can you hear me?
Who are you? What's going on?
My name's Kate Bowman. I'm an engineer. I was part of the team assigned to bring this asteroid to Terra Nova.
We were attacked yesterday by Batarian extremists. I've been hiding since they arrived. I think they know the torch went out.
Why are they doing this?
I don't know, but if this asteroid isn't slowed, millions of people on Terra Nova are going to die.
If I find out anything, I'll...
I've gotta go. Good luck.
I didn't mean to... Are you hurt?
Takes more than that one shot to bring me down.
Sorry. I didn't even realize you were human until... Well, guess I'm not much of a soldier.
I know you're scared, but I'm here to help. Commander Shepard, with the Alliance.
Simon Atwell. I'm the chief engineer on this rock. Listen, we don't have much time. The Batarians fired up the fusion torches. You've got to shut them down before we hit Terra Nova. There are 4 million people down there, Shepard. My family. They live in Aronus. My kids and grandkids. Nice communities. Good schools.
I don't have time to do the math in my head. What happens if we don't stop this rock?
X-57 is 22 kilometers long, twice the size of the asteroid that wiped out the Earth's dinosaurs. It would be like millions of fusion bombs striking at once. Millions. The heat of the blazon kilometers away, clothes will ignite. There'll be global wildfires. Air shock will flatten everything for hundreds of kilometers. Terra Nova will die, Shepard. Not just our colony, the planet. There'll be a climate shift, mass extinctions. The ecosystem won't recover for thousands of years. Millions, maybe.
Batarians everywhere, and I need to shut down all three torches. Anything else I should know?
One of the torches is surrounded by live blasting caps. We were set up to excavate when we arrived at Terra Nova. I rigged them with proximity detectors. That tank of yours will set them off, so you'll have to go in on foot. Even then, they'll explode if you get too close. Just go slow and easy. You should be fine.
Should I requisition a cow to walk through ahead of me?
Look, you can disable them, just not remotely. I didn't have the equipment to set it up differently. There are manual controls by the entrance to the torch facility inside the blast zone. You can disarm the caps there. One last thing. I had a crew working off-site when the attack hit. I'm worried about them. These Batarians are ruthless. I saw them smash the faceplates of guys working vacuum. And those Varan, I don't think they always wait for a corpse before feeding.
Any idea where I can find them?
They were running checks on our perimeter equipment. Easiest thing would be to tap into the transmission tower out on the surface. The equipment stations will show up on your sensors.
I came across a member of your crew. He didn't make it.
I see. Well, maybe the other two are still out there. You never know. There were a bunch of engineers over at the main facility, but they're probably all dead. That or being held hostage by the Batarians.
Time's running short. I better get moving.
I think I'll make myself scarce in case any Batarians come back. Good luck, Shepard.
Sorry, there's a lot of feedback. If I can fix it. In the meantime, just keep doing...